Hello, my name is Belova Anna. The topic of my report is threshold behavior of convective flows as thermal lens oscillation. A threshold behavior of supermaximum flows, excitation is significant both practically and scientifically. As it's known, there are following control parameters, way and Marangoni numbers, concerning the initiation of convective flows at different conditions. Our interest to the problem of convective processes in fluids is connected with the study of so-called thermal length oscillation or optical coherence. The well-known thermal self-defocusing or thermal length effect develops in an absorbing medium because of its thermal expansion and as a result of the reduction of medium refractive index in the region where the beam power is enough high. Then the laser beam self-broadening is observable as a specific enlarged circular symmetrical pattern, a thermal lens aberration, a set of interference screen on the screen after passing through the medium. It is this non-linear optical phenomenon that is named thermal self-defocusing. The photo instead demonstrates a thermal lens aberration observed on the screen as second. Circular symmetry of the pattern is formed by three stationary thermal convective flows. If the depth of the laser beam passed under the fluid surface is decreased, the static character of convective flows may be substituted by oscillatory and Hopf bifurcation occurs. Evidently, it's allowable to consider thermal convection flows as ones arising from the relative instability at the limits of small Edward number at the infinity instability. At the proconvective state of thermal lens oscillation, the potential energy storage occurs. This model of accumulate and fire behavior might be termed as capillary gravitational mode. However, it's seen that at small depths, the potential barrier height tends to infinity. And thermal lens oscillation has to be stopped, while in experiment this termination is not observed. We suppose that at small depths thermal capillary mode of oscillation is relevant. To illustrate the accumulate and fire behaviors in the thermal capillary oscillation mode, we recall the remarkable experiment with the salt film between the two waves. The salt film interface has a form of catenoid. Externally symmetric surface with minimal tension and area. Two solutions on stable and unstable branches are appeared. It's a stable solution that is observable, but a critical behavior is demonstrated when the distance between the rings is formed. It corresponds to the catenoid breakdown. We suppose the same scheme of the critical behaviors is a base to excite the convective flows and the thermal capillary mode of optical qubits. Initially, at the accumulative phase of oscillation, a meniscus of the liquid in the cell has a form of half cylindrical surface in the case of full weighting. Stretching of the surface meniscus occurs because of the thermal capillary force action, by analogy with the stretching of the salt film. It's natural to assume the form of the stretched meniscus segment is rather similar to the catenoid surface. Moreover, this assumption is consistent with the Prigozhin principle of minimized entropy production. Therefore, the start-up of the convection flows occurs after catenoid area becomes unstable and at its above-mentioned critical state. Finally, our conclusions. We have examined the phenomenon of the convective flows excitation at laser-induced thermal lens self-oscillation in liquid near its interface. The accumulate and fire oscillation behavior testifies that threshold mechanisms are present at the near-interface convective flows excitation. Two threshold modes, capillary gravitational and thermocapillary, has suggested. Both mechanisms appear to differ qualitatively from well-known delay and Marangoni threshold because of their existence even in the fluid of zero viscosity. Read for your attention.